When we at CHI introduced DHEA supplementation in women with low functional ovarian reserve, our studies demonstrated that we started seeing significant improvements in clinical pregnancy rates after roughly 6 weeks of DHEA supplementation. In those days, we really did not understand how DHEA worked, why it improved pregnancy rates. Since then, we have learned that DHEA is converted to testosterone and that testosterone through the androgen receptor on granulosa cells affects quality of follicular development. Since we understand that, we also understand that the active hormone, the hormone that really gives us those benefits on egg quality, is testosterone. And therefore, we now have an objective way of assessing whether a patient has had appropriate exposure to DHEA for long enough time. And we do that by testing testosterone levels. And we want to make sure that the patient on DHEA, before we put in an IVF cycle, has appropriate testosterone levels. In practical terms, that means that we want her testosterone levels to go back to where they used to be when she was younger, since as we all get older, our testosterone levels drop particularly rapidly after age 35 to 38. So the range that we're trying to attain is roughly mid-range of normal range, and if possible even a little above the mid-range of normal range, and that applies to all the androgens, but the important one again is testosterone. We also test other androgens. We test DHEA and DHEAS, DHEA sulfate. Probably the most important androgen after testosterone is indeed DHEAS, because that is only produced by adrenals, and since in the woman roughly half of her male hormones come from the ovary and half from the adrenals, DHEAS allows us to determine whether a patient's low androgen levels are caused by adrenal insufficiency or ovarian insufficiency. And that is an increasingly important observation now, since we have, over the last 2 years, defined a very specific condition called hypoandrogenic PCOS, which is associated with low androgen levels, which exclusively are caused by poor adrenal function, even though the clinical presentation is the same as it would be if androgen levels were poor due to ovarian function. The differentiation is very important, because in such patients, supplementation with DHEA is even more effective than in women where the low androgen levels are derived from the ovaries.